Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another edition of Ask the ND. I'm Dr. Jeremy Wolf. Today, I wanted to spend some time talking to you about vitamin K. Vitamin K has long been known for its role in blood clotting. However, it has more benefits than most people are aware of. New research shows that it may be essential for many other important functions in our body. Vitamin K is a fat-soluble vitamin, which means you need to be eating fats for its absorption. Foods such as avocado and coconut oil are some examples of healthy fats you can eat to make sure you're absorbing your vitamin K. The K is derived from the German word coagulation, which means to clot. New research shows that vitamin K is critical in controlling calcium. In other words, it helps to put calcium where we want it, like in our bones and teeth, and removes it from where it shouldn't be, like your blood vessels. Vitamin K works in conjunction with other fat-soluble vitamins in our body, like vitamin A and D. So what else does it do for us in our body? Here's the rundown. Vitamin K plays a key role in forming blood clots. This is what helps you to stop bleeding when you scrape your knee or cut yourself. Recent evidence shows that vitamin K may help play a role in preventing heart disease, osteoporosis, diabetes, some cancers, and Alzheimer's disease. Vitamin K is crucial for bone formation and repair. It also helps prevent plaque formation in our arteries, which keeps our blood vessels healthy and may decrease the risk of heart disease. Vitamin K comes in many forms. Vitamin K1, or phylloquinone, comes from plants and green leafy vegetables. Vitamin K2, or menaquinone, is made by our intestinal bacteria and is found in foods such as butter, chicken, egg yolks, and fermented soybean products like natto. Vitamin K3, or menadione, is a synthetic form and should be avoided. It's best to increase vitamin K levels through our diet by increasing fermented foods. However, if that's not possible, vitamin K2 is the preferred form of supplementation. Vitamin K2 can be broken down even further into two additional subtypes: MK4, which is found in animal-based products, and MK7, which is found in fermented foods like cheese and natto. This is the best form for supplementation. I recommend a dosage between 45 micrograms and 185 micrograms, depending on your current health status. If you're taking drugs such as warfarin or other blood thinners, you must consult your physician to monitor your dosage. Always remember to see your healthcare provider before starting any supplements. Thank you for watching another edition of Ask the ND. From all of us here at Lucky Vitamin, spread the wellness.